As an editor of weather, my main responsibility is to manage the articles which are submitted to the journal, including overseeing the peer review process and then making final decisions on manuscripts. The editors also organise the articles which go into each issue of the journal and proof the final copy of the issue before it goes off to print. I also co-lead the editorial board and plan the journal strategy, which includes organising special issues, commissioning content, and also liaising with the editors of the other RMetS journals. I also work with the society more widely, including sitting on the awards committee and also working to promote engagement, especially among early career scientists like myself. I've loved my time so far as co-editor of Weather, which I've been doing now since September 2020. I'll admit that at first it was quite daunting, as I'd always pictured editors as middle or late stage scientists, so I never expected to be in the position myself at this stage of my career. But once I settled in, I found that the experience has increased my academic confidence, and I also feel that as an early career scientist, I can offer a perspective on the academic appetite of the new generation, so to speak, which ensures that the journal can stay relevant as we move into the future. I've learned so much about the process behind producing journals, all the way from what happens to a manuscript when it's first submitted to its final appearance in a published issue. Even though I've published a few papers before joining Weather, I understand the procedure so much more now sitting on this side of the table. And it's increased my patience with articles that I submit to journals, as now I have a first-hand experience of why the process can sometimes become a little slow. And in addition, because I've read so many articles now with a critical eye, I think it's not just improved my wider meteorological knowledge and in related fields, but it's also improved my academic writing, or at least I hope so. I believe all PhD students and early career professionals more generally should allocate time for their professional development, be that in the form of reviewing papers or serving on an editorial board, or in my case, being an editor. And fundamentally, this shouldn't be seen as a distraction from doing research, because it should help equip you with the skills that will be of great benefit to you in your future career, and also help you do that research to the best of your ability. And actually, even though being an editor in absolute terms has taken time away from me doing research, I believe it's actually helped me be more productive with what time I have remaining. And actually, overall, I think I've achieved more than I would have done otherwise. For example, it's forced me to have a managed to-do list and to organize my time much better than I did before. First off, I think every early career scientist should not be afraid to review papers. Editorially, I often find that early career scientists do a particularly great job at reviewing, which might be because they have fewer commitments, but I think it's also because they have a great understanding of the current state of the literature. Although it can be time consuming, I would say that the benefit to your own ability to write a good research article, as well as to realise just how much you do know about your own subject, outweighs any negatives. And we're also keen and willing to have any early career scientists sit on our editorial board in a more formal capacity to have a greater say in the outputs of our journal. We really value having early career professionals involved in Weather, because it enables a more even playing field, so to speak, across the generations in academia. Early career researchers are quite literally the future, so we need to know what they want and how they feel. A journal like Weather is 75 years old this year, and the world has changed a lot in that time, and now we have an entirely different audience to what we did when the journal first launched. Early career professionals often have their finger on the pulse, so to speak, of the latest research output and the direction of it, with often the greatest knowledge in their specific subject area, and they're increasingly well connected. Journals need this. Well, my first bit of advice is, if you have the chance, do it. Especially if you're the kind of person who is willing to take on a position and make it your own, and you would like to get more involved with academic publishing. Keep growing your network and your profile online, especially nowadays, that's increasingly important. And don't be afraid to discuss possible opportunities with editorial board members, even those that you might not know so well. It is a voluntary position, so if you're keen, you can definitely make it yours.